another. Second one awakes his next door brother. Three awaken, rise the town and turn the whole place upside down. Many awake will cause such a fuss. And finally wakes all of us. One man awakes with dawn in his eyes. Surely then it multiplies. Surely then it multiplies. Surely then it multiplies. Yeah.
Afternoon po sa ating lahat. Ako po si Maurice Gozum at kasama niyo po ako ngayon na mag-host sa hapon na ito. Before po tayo mag-start, kung kasama niyo po ang iyong tatay at nanay, mga kapatid, dyan po sa inyong tabi, bigyan niyo po ng high five. Wala akong katabi, so yun. At sabihin niyo po, today I choose joy over this pandemic. And kaya ko po sinabi na today I choose joy because we have so many reasons na bakit tayo magpapasalamat sa ating Panginoon. Nandyan na yung binibigyan niya tayo ng everyday chance na, you know, mabuhay at bigyan ng kalakasan. So before po tayo mag-start, tayo po ay manalangin. Father Lord God, we lift up our hands to you. May every home be filled and overflow with your spirit of praise and change the spiritual atmosphere in every house in the mighty name of Jesus and in every place right now. May our hearts be filled with thanksgiving. Thank you for this, Jesus, because, you know, Lord, we have all the reason to thank you. Because you are faithful and you are so good to us all the time. Lord, we give you all the highest praise, the highest honor. We bring back the glory and honor to you in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. So lahat, so tayo po ay dadako na sa ating praise and worship na pangungunahan po ng Iliko family.
Sa habang panahon, sa bawat saling lahi, katapatan mo ay naroon, aming Diyos. Wala namang ibang Panginoon. Aming Diyos, kay buti mo. Sa habang panahon, sa bawat salilahi, katapatan mo ay naroon, aming Diyos. Wala namang ibang Panginoon. Ang pag-ibig mo ay tunay at walang kapantay. Kapangyarihan mo'y walang katulad. Mula pa noon hanggang ngayon, sa habang panahon, sa bawat salita, katapatan mo ay naroon, aming Diyos. Wala namang ibang Panginoon. Aming Diyos, kay buti mo panoon hanggang ngayon at sa habang panahon, sa bawat saling lahat, katapatan mo ay naroon, aming Diyos. Wala namang ibang Panginoon. Ang pag-ibig mo ay tunay at wala walang katulad. Pupurihin ka ng lahat na may buhay. Ang pag-ibig mo ay tunay at walang kapantay. Kapangyarihan mo ay walang katulad. Pupurihin ka ng lahat na may buhay. Aming Diyos, kay buti mo sa habang panahon, sa bawat salita, katapatan mo ay naroon, aming Diyos. Wala nang ibang Panginoon. Wala nang ibang Panginoon. Wala nang
ah.
gawin mo, purihin ka.
Hallelujah. Thank you po, Iliku family, for leading us in worship, praise and worship. At ngayon po ay dadako na po tayo sa ating communion. I-ready po natin ang ating mga gagamitin. At ito po ay pangungunahan po ng ating butihing sister, na si Sister Esther.
Hello po, ngayon po tayo po ay magkakasama-sama sa pagpartake po ng ating communion. So, ating pong ihanda ang ating mga element sa pagpartake po natin. Yan po ay kinabibilangan po ng tinapay na nagsisimbolo po yan sa katawan ng ating Panginoong Jesus, at ang wine, sorrow, or juice po na nagsisimbolo po yan sa dugo ng ating Panginoong Jesus. Sa pagpartake po ng ating communion, yan po ay bilang pag-alala o paggunita po sa kaligtasan na ating natamo sa pamamagitan po ng pagkakapako ng ating Panginoong Jesus dun po sa krus ng Kalbaryo. At ito rin po ay paggunita sa pagmamahal ng ating Panginoon, kaya po ay kanyang inalay ang kanyang bugtong na anak upang ating pong makamit ang kaligtasan. Sa pagkakapako din po ng ating Panginoong Jesus, ay nais rin po niya na tayo po ay magkaroon ng malalim na relasyon sa ating Panginoon upang makamit po natin ang pangako na ibinigay ng ating Panginoong Jesus na magkaroon ng buhay na walang hanggan kung tayo po ay manampalataya sa Kanya. Paano po natin makamit ang buhay na walang hanggan? Ito po ay sa pamamagitan po ng pamumuhay natin na may takot sa Kanya, pamumuhay po ng matuwid, at lalong-lalo na po, mamuhay po tayo kagaya po ng pamumuhay na ginawa po ng ating Panginoong Jesus nung siya po ay nagkatawang tao dito sa lupa. So, ang sabi nga po sa kanyang aklat na 1 Peter chapter 3 verse 18, "For Christ also suffered once for sin, the righteous for unrighteous, to bring you to God. He put to death in the body but made alive in the spirit." So, sabi nga po sa atin ng ating Panginoon ay tayo po ay manatiling mamuhay na may kapayapaan at mamuhay na matuwid dito sa lupa. So, habang tayo po ay naghahanda ng ating mga sarili ay sa pagparti ng ating komunyon, ay ating rin pong isa puso ang pagpartake at seryosohin po natin. Dahil po, through this communion po, tayo po ay makakaranas ng kagalingan. Iyan po ay naaayon sa ating pananampalataya. So, kagalingan po, i-declare po natin ang kagalingan sa bawat isa sa atin. So, atin po ngayon magbigay ng panalangin sa ating Panginoon bago po tayo magpartake. Panginoon, salamat po sa mga oras na ibinigay mo sa bawat isa sa amin. Salamat po ay kami po ay nagkasama-samang muli po for taking a communion para God. Salamat Panginoon sa pag-alala mo sa amin, Panginoon, na kung paano mo kami, Panginoon, na iligtas sa pamamagitan ng iyong bugtong na anak ni Jesus. Salamat Panginoon sa iyong bugtong na anak ni Jesus na iginawad mo, Panginoon, para kami po ay maligtas doon sa krus, Panginoon ko. Panginoon, inaalay po namin ang araw na to, Panginoon, at inihiling po namin sa iyo, Panginoon, ang kapatawaran, Panginoon, at kagalingan para God, through partaking this communion, Panginoon, igawad mo ang kagalingan sa bawat isa sa aming, Panginoon, kagalingan sa aming physical, kagalingan sa spiritual at emotional para God. At salamat, Panginoon, sa dugo ng iyong bugtong na anak ng Jesus na nalinis kami, Panginoon, sa aming mga kasalanan, Panginoon ko. Panginoon, inaalay po namin ang lahat ng ito, Panginoon, at igawad mo, Panginoon, ang kapayapaan, kasaganaan sa bawat isa sa aming Panginoon ko, at bigyan mo po kami ng kapayapaan at patuloy, Panginoon, ang proteksyon mo sa bawat isa sa amin, at paalala mo, Panginoon, sa bawat isa sa amin na mamuhay kami, Panginoon, na ayon sa iyong kalooban. Ang lahat ng ito, Panginoon, ay ibinibigay po namin sa iyo sa bugtong mong anak na si Jesus. Amen. So, ating pong kunin ang tinapay at itaas po. At i-declare po natin na through this bread na nagsisimbolo po sa katawan ng ating Panginoong Yesus na nagkasugat-sugat dahil sa atin, ay tayo po ay nagtamo ng kagalingan sa ating mga espiritual at physical. So, receive healing sa ating buhay at sa ating mga katawan. Kung ano man po nararamdaman mo ngayon, brother and sister, just accept and receive healing. Claim it in the name of Jesus. So partake. Ito naman po ang juice o nagsisimbolo po ito ng dugo ng ating Panginoong Jesus na naglinis po sa ating mga kasalanan. So, tayo po magpasalamat sa pamamagitan po ng dugo ng ating Panginoong Jesus. Tayo po ay naligtas at nahugasan sa ating mga kasalanan. So, salamat po. So, salamat brother and sister na tayo po ay nagkasama-samang muli sa pag-partake. Nawa hanggang sa susunod na linggo po, and mamuhay po tayo ng may kapayapaan, and God bless all. Thank you po.
Ating or should I say sa pinaka-exciting na part, ito po yung pagbibigay ng tithes at offering po natin. Napangungunahan po ni Brother Allen.
Good afternoon everyone. Nandito po ako ngayon to bring you tithes and offering. At bago ko basahin ang ating verse for today, I would just like to give you some insights or mga bagay na kailangan nating malaman, kailangan nating matutunan about giving. So, pag sinabi po natin giving is divided into for us na mga mananampalataya. First is the tithe or the tithing. So, what is tithing? Tithing is giving our 10% ng income natin to the Lord. We offer it to the Lord dahil alam natin and we acknowledge that everything or the ability na magkamal tayo ng mga kinikita natin ay nanggagaling sa Panginoon. So, we should give the Lord yung due para sa Kanya. So, 10% is just a basis, no? Not necessarily kukumpitin natin. Probably, it will be the minimum, but it is just a basis. We can give 20-30% is up to us, no? Dahil sinabi po sa New Testament na it depends on our heart kung ano ang hindi mabigat o hindi yung kung saan tayo magiging masaya sa pagbibigay. Second is the offering. So, ano man itong klase itong pagbibigay ng offering? So, offering is kung ano man yung mga binibigay natin, outside dun sa 10% or outside dun sa tithes natin. So we offer, dahil meron tayong gustong tulungan, we offer dahil like this one sa ating church, sa may mga activities, may mga kailangan mga bayaran, utilities, na certain project para sa atin. So, in our giving, God is acknowledged, God is loved, and we obey His commandments. Kaya, sa ngayon po ay basahin ko sa inyo ang makikita natin dito sa Galatians. In Galatians 6, sabi po dito in verse 9 and 10, ang sabi niya, let us not become weary in doing good. For the proper time, we will reap a harvest if we do not give up. So therefore, as we have opportunity, let us do good to all people, especially to those who belong to the family of believers. So ang sabi po ng talata dito is, ini-encourage ni Pablo na church in Galatians, and of course, he's also encouraging us that huwag tayong mabagot, huwag tayong magsawa sa paggawa ng mabuti. Dahil sa takdang panahon ay tayo ay aani, no? Hindi po nangangahulugan dito na aani tayo ng material blessing as well, because we provide our tithes and offering in terms sa halaga ng pera na binibigay natin. No, it is all about spiritual blessing. Aani tayo. Sabi pa niya dito, do good, no? Gawin yung mabuti, no? Especially for those who are within the church. Yung mga kapatiran, yung mga kapwa mananampalataya natin. Dahil anong ma-reap natin dito? Anong matutunghayan natin dito? We will reap blessing, no? Blessing, spiritual blessing. We will have more friends. Magkakaroon tayo ng kapayapaan. Magkakaroon tayo ng, magre-reap tayo ng kagalakan. Magre-reap tayo ng love because what we are doing for the people of God. So, yun po ang mahalagang bagay na pinagpapala tayo spiritually ng Panginoon dahil sa ating pagbibigay. Kaya sa araw po ito, ang ating focus for our offering is Turning Point Food Support. So, ang ating pong church, Turning Point, specifically yung Cranbourne, is doing a community work. Community work to bless and help those who are in need, especially sa larangan po ng mga pangangailangan nila sa araw-araw. So we're providing food parcels, food packages, counseling, support, ano man ang kailangan, ano, na ng mga tao, especially in the area of the city of KC. Marami na po itong natulungan, lalo na sa ating mga international students, Filipino students na talagang naghirap, nangailangan nung time nung nag-start ng pandemic. At hanggang ngayon, marami pong matutulungan. Kaya, I encourage you, brothers and sisters, na magbigay tayo generously for this cause. Dahil ang ginagawa po nito is to bring Christ to the community. And ang magre-result naman nito, yung community naman ay madadala sa ating Panginoon. So brothers and sisters, I remind you na huwag tayong magsawa sa paggawa ng ating ng mabuti sa ating mga kapwa para sa kalukuran at kaluwalhatian ng ating Panginoon. So mabibigay po natin ang ating tithes through online sa ating website by clicking give. At yung cost nito is for Turning Point Food Support. Tayo po'y manalangin. Panginoon, maraming salamat sa oras na ito dahil you provided us all our needs. Salamat, Panginoon, dahil kayo ang nakunalas namin na nagbibigay at magbibigay ng aming mga pangangailangan. Salamat din po, Panginoon, dahil sa iyo po namin itinitiwala ang lahat ng aming pagkakaloob At dalangin namin ang lahat ng ito ay magamit sa inyong kaluwalhatian. Lahat ng ito ay magamit, Panginoon, sa inyong mga gawain dito sa daang ito. Salamat po at pagpapalain mo po ang bawat isa sa pangalan ni Jesus. Amen.
Turning Point Church for being willing to come on board with this, and straight away your senior pastor said yes, we'll do this, and there was no convincing.
All right, thank you.
Gloria, and here are your TP notices. First of all, you may know that Enlarge is the theme of this term, and we are really jumping on the course to help us with that. This term, we are doing the Alpha course. We are doing three different Alpha courses to suit you. That's Alpha Talks, Alpha Youth, and the Marriage course. So make sure you ask your Connect Group leaders for more information. Now, Alpha is an awesome opportunity to invite your friends, invite your family, your neighbors, your co-workers, invite everyone, because this is a very simple way to connect, make friends, but more importantly, hear about Christianity and learn about Jesus. Number two, the AGM is coming up next Sunday, so we want you to be there. Members, it is compulsory for you to be there. So jump on our website right now, that's turningpointchurches.org.au, to ensure that you are registered for our AGM. Another way that we're enlarging this term is through our awesome friend, Pastor Brett Lindner. Pastor Brett is not just an awesome preacher, he is a healing evangelist. The important thing is this is another opportunity to invite your friends, invite your family, invite those who you know are sick, who you know need a touch from God, and invite them to come and see the miraculous work of God. So have you been feeling the travel bug lately? I definitely have been itching to go out, to be in a plane, to be traveling to another country, but we can't do that. So here's another way that you can travel. in style, and all you need to know is OCC Shoeboxes Operation Christmas Child. We do this every year. This year we're not able to gather and pick up things and drive as free as we could last year. So in knowing that, Katie Batson has packed hundreds of box packages that you can just purchase online and still bless a child or bless 20, 30, 40, hundreds of children with the gospel and with some awesome little gifts to show the love of Jesus.
Amen. So ready na po ba tayong makinig ng mensahe na pangungunahan po ni Sister Haidee? Nasa series pa rin po tayo ng Enlarge. At personally po, itong series na to nakaka-encourage kasi sa totoo lang ito po yung utos sa atin ng ating Panginoon na pagpapalaganap at pagpapalawak ng kanyang salita. So tayo po ay maghanda at makinig po.
Magandang hapon po mga kapatid. Samahan niyo po ako sa pag-aaral ng ating salita ng Panginoon. Bago po muna ito, let's all pray. Father God in heaven, we thank you Lord God for the opportunity to preach the word of salvation, O Lord God, to people. Teach us today, O Lord God, and let your Holy Spirit allow us, O Lord God, to be in tune to the heart of Christ. Lord God, teach us, O Lord God, that your word will be our living hope, O Lord God, especially in this time of pandemic, Lord. Lord, we are so grateful for the opportunity that you had given to every one of us. Let your word be an example that will gonna lead our lives, O Lord God, with a good hope, O Lord God, that we have it, O Lord God, the future that we have in you, Lord God, is always true, O Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, for your word, and we ask this in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Samahan niyo po ako mga kapatid for our term, topic about enlarge. The word enlarge in the dictionary, it says that the greater in quantity, dimension, to extend in limit, to expand in bulk or to increase, to grow large or larger. So this month of our term about enlarge, I want to share only just 2 points: enlarge our prayer and enlarge our vision of God. About enlarging our prayer, the prayer of Jabez in the Bible. Jabez means pain. God make him honorable against his brothers by the authentic heart of blessing and enlarging his territory. Seeing the vision of God though he is in pain or in suffering, God counted him honorable because of his pure cry out of prayer, humbleness, and faith. It was found in 1 Chronicles 4:9-10, Jabez was more honorable than his brother. His mother has named him Jabez, saying, I gave birth to him in pain. Jabez cried out to the Lord, to the God of Israel, oh, that you will bless me and enlarge my territory. Let your hand be with me and keep me from harm, so that I will be free from pain. And God granted his prayer. This is just a simple prayer that Jabez was being known honorable by the Lord. by the prayer that he has been, you know, given, it's just only the cry out of his heart. Though he is in pain, he didn't much have that attention about anything else but to ask God with an authentic heart. So, when have you been prayed like Jabez? Have you prayed like when we cry out to God, believing that there's a power in our prayer? Have you asked God to bless you and enlarge your territory? Have you asked God in faith in times of troubles, pain, or trials? These are the common questions that we normally ask ourselves. But prayer is the most important thing that God has given to us. It also has helped us to enlarge our vision of God, our territory, our potential, and our opportunity. We are all journeyed in prayer, and the kind of prayer we do is the power of God to change our attitudes towards God. Prayer changes everything. In my life, I always have the answered prayer because I know that when I pray to God, I believe that there is something that will gonna happen. It is not my timeline, but God's timeline. It changes our attitudes and approach to God's holiness. Sometimes we feel like when we pray to God, sometimes we feel like our prayers have not been answered the way we are expecting it. But when we believe that there is power in prayer, we were able to understand the heart of God. Prayer helps us to understand where we are at God. Sometimes when a person, or especially in a group, say that we say a prayer and we've been asked to pray, sometimes we are so hesitant to do it. But when we understand this kind of prayer that Jabez was just giving in to the Lord, it helps us to understand the authenticity of the heart when we cry out to God. God matters everything that we do. He knows the intentions of our hearts. God doesn't change. He is the God of yesterday, today, and forevermore. We change as we learn to pray. We become aligned to the will of God and the hearts of God. That's the power of prayer. Jesus and the Samaritan woman in John 4:1-43 is another scripture that I want to share to you. It was says that Jesus knew the Pharisees that he was baptizing and making more disciples than John. Jesus himself did not baptize them, his disciple did. So he left Judea and returned to Galilee. We had to go through Samaria on that way. Eventually, he came to the Samaritan village of Sychar, near the field of Jacob that Jacob gave to his son Joseph. Jacob's well was there, and Jesus, tired from a long walk, sat wearily beside the well about noontime. Soon, as the Samaritan woman came to draw water, Jesus said to her, "Please give me a drink." He was alone at that time because his disciple had gone into the village to buy some food. This is the story of Jesus Christ going to a certain direction from Judea to Galilee after a Sermon of the Mount. Why the people doesn't want to go and drop by on Samaria? There are reasons. But Jesus has to go to Samaria because God the Father had tasked him to do. Samaria, where Jesus took the direct route north from Jerusalem to Galilee through Samaria, in contrast to most Jewish who took the longer indirect route east to the River Jordan through the Perea because of their hatred for the Samaritans. The Samaritans were the descendants of the Israelites of the Northern Kingdom who had intermarried with foreign settlers after the fall of Samaria, the capital of the Northern Kingdoms of Israel. As a result of this racial intermarriage, they were no longer considered to be truly Jewish, and they were hated the most Jews. The Samaritan continues to worship as the Jewish did, but took only the first five books of the Old Testament as their spiritual authority. They built a rival temple of the Mount Gerizim, which they believed to be the site of the altar where Abraham prepared to offer the son of Isaac as a sacrifice. But this was destroyed by the Hasmonean king John Hyrcanus in 128 BC. At that time, that Jesus encountered with Samaritan woman at the Mount of Gerizim, it was still a holy place, and even up today. So we can see that people doesn't want to go to that place because they hated the people in that place. But Jesus has to go another route. So the story of Samaritan woman and on the well, Jesus has to go intentionally, where people excuses to go for a reason. Have a conversation to people and passion to preach the word. We can see that the heart of Jesus Christ was to those people, especially for the outcasts. We can see that there is water representing the living water, which is Jesus was offering the Holy Spirit, and the bread where the disciples was trying to get for them to satisfy their physical body. And Jesus was saying in this scripture that He is the bread of life. Enlarging our vision of God, we need to look at the story of the Samaritan woman, the Jesus' intentions in going to that place. People excuses to go places where they are not comfortable. People will not find time and effort where they think they are not welcome. They are afraid of their inconvenience. So, in the story that we have read, the scenario was Jesus has to go to Samaria. So for us as a Christian, we have to go to places where God wants us to be. We have to go on a different route from our own personal agenda. Jesus even was tired from a long walk after the sermon in the mount. So he was walking, and the disciple was walking almost 3 days to go from Judea to Galilee. So physically, Jesus was so tired, but it doesn't stop him to go to Samaria. Jesus need to start a conversation to the woman on the well. We can see that there is a big gap about the women and the men talking to each other, especially in the place where they call it Samaria. So we can see that God started a conversation to that woman and doesn't hesitate or even, you know, not giving him inconvenience to know how this lady would be, how his life, you know, is working. Jesus has to send his disciple away for a while to get some food. Sometimes we need to be alone in a bigger group of our crowd just to be able to find ourselves in the real calling of God. Jesus need to give us an opportunity where only us had been tasked to do it. Sometimes we find help with our brothers, with our sisters, with our leaders, but there are times that only you and God has been tasked for you to a specific task. Jesus had to tell God's love and promise of salvation. Sometimes we have to go in some places where we are not comfortable, where we are not welcome, but We are tasked to do something that God wants us to do, to accomplish. And if your heart is not aligned to God in our prayer, in your prayer, you will refuse. You will find other agenda. Now we can see that every one of us has been given by a different giftings, and one of us, over all of us, can be used by God through His purpose. Enlarging our vision to God, meaning we have to know the purpose that God has saved us. In 2 Timothy 1:9, who has saved us and called us with a holy calling, not according to our works, but according to His own purpose and grace, which was given us in Christ Jesus before the world began. We can understand that from this scripture in 2 Timothy 1:9, that you and me who had been who had been accepting Christ, who had been saved, has a calling, God, and it is a holy calling from the Lord. It is not for our own sake, but it is also for the purpose and the grace of God. So knowing our God for who He is, it changes our perspective. For whoever seen the light, it is impossible to live a life in darkness. In John 1:5, it says that the light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. Does not overcome it. If you experience God's miracle today in your life and see the truth that it is impossible for you to unsee, then the eyes had been opened. Your eyes had been opened and able to see now in the lens of God. So it is impossible that whenever you experience God, your life will never be the same again. It is your responsibility to take it is our responsibility to take things what we have received from God. Who is our final authority in our lives? Our faith and belief is affected of who He is in charge in our lives. So what drives you to do things? Who influences you to think and decide? The Word of God should be our final authority, and understand that why is it should be our driving force to move forward towards God's purpose in our life. 2 Timothy 3:10, the final charge to Timothy, you whoever knows that all about my teaching, my way of life, my purpose, my faith, patience, love, and endurance, persecution, suffering, what kind of things happened to me in Antioch, Iconium, and Lystra, and persecution I endured, yet the Lord rescued me from all of them. In fact, everyone who wants to live a godly life in Christ Jesus will be persecuted, while evildoers and impostors will go from bad to worse, deceiving and being deceived. But as for you, continue in what you have learned and have become convinced of, because you know those from whom you learned it, and how from infancy you have known the Holy Scriptures, which are able to make you wise for salvation through faith in Jesus Christ. And then in verse 16, it says that all Scriptures of God breath and is useful for teaching, rebuking, correcting, and training in righteousness, so that the servant of God may be thoroughly equipped in every good works. So every one of us had experience. Even Paul and Timothy was experiencing a lot of things doing the work of God. But in our lives, it assures us that only the Scripture, the Holy Bible, the Word of God is our final authority. It is where we have receiving good teaching of Jesus Christ, the rebuking and correcting and training us in righteousness, so that our hearts will be aligned to God. So every one of us had experienced those things, especially if you know that the Word of God is the final authority in your life. My testimony, God found me in March 8, 1998 by someone who shared the gospel to me in one of the shopping centers in the Philippines. It is the right day and the right time appointed by God. The passion is I live right now. I have grown God's passion by experiencing Him and allowing His Word to be the final authority and how I should live my life. My life is not my own. It is God's purpose. In Psalm 16:8 says that I know the Lord is always with me. I will not be shaken, for He is right beside me. I started joining outreach ministry by reaching out street children in Metro Manila, feeding them and teaching them God's word, praising in prayer and worship in songs. Though I'm a young Christian at that time, it doesn't stop me from doing God's work through that ministry. I am grateful to God for all the leaders, the pastors and the ministers whom I worked for in the past years. My journey with them prepares me to for God's work. I did not go to a proper Bible school, but the ministry of the Holy Spirit teaches me the deep things of God. I've teached God's word in the Bible study small groups, water baptisms in adult and youth, and discipleship, and preaching God's message and evangelizing, and learning the Holy Spirit's works and the passion to reach out for the souls. While doing these things for the ministry, my son was diagnosed from leukemia, AAL, a blood cancer, and my husband during those period of times were also suffering from a rare disease of meningitis. Both of them were in the hospital, yet my faith that God can do miracles. On those days, and my faith of God has grown more, not from the absence of trials and circumstances, but that how I cling more to God, God's mercy and love. 3 years ago, I got a car accident and I survived thanks to the Lord. He never leave me nor forsake me during those situations. I know God is doing something very big in my life. Thus, the enemy is trying to stop me. For the next 3 months, I didn't drive at all. Or, you know, when I drive, I can drive without fear. But thanks to God, reminding me of His goodness and His word. God says that I always been reminded by the word of God in Psalm 91, verse 14 to 16. It says that God says, I will save those who love me and will protect those who acknowledge me as Lord. And when they call to me, I will answer them. And when they are in trouble, I will be with them. And I will rescue them and honor them. And I will reward them with long life. And I will save them. This is the scripture that God has given to me. I think it was 10 years ago. And still alive at this moment. And this is the revelation that had given to me by the Lord. And every time I read the Psalm 91 every year of my life, I see to it that there is a new beginning for me, a protection and another opportunity for God. My passion is to share what God has done for my life and what He's still doing in my life. I believe that the anointing of God is to prepare us for the work of the Holy Spirit. I planted the seed of faith and God's words to people, but the Holy Spirit has the last say of it to grow. Presently, God leads me to enroll and study God's words at Turning Point School of Ministry, which prepares me for whatever God will lead me in the future. Just as last week, I received a message from the Philippines. And my uncle was in the hospital. During this time of COVID-19, it is really unimaginable. He was in the hospital and asked my family to pray. Right then and then, I knew it is not just a prayer for healing, but also for salvation. Though he died the next day, the unity of the family to pray was the miracle of God manifested in that situation. Death of our loved ones is a reminder for the living. And my sister in Sweden accepted God, which I've been praying for an answered prayer for me this year. This was some of the miracles that God has been working in my life. Since the last year that I have joined Turning Point, I shared the gospel to one family and they have accepted God as their Lord and personal Savior. God empowered us for the Holy Spirit to do His work in the kingdom of God. I may not have a big crowd of people, but every year of my life, I make sure that God will gonna send someone or somebody for me to minister His word. God is showing His great love to every one of us, and we need to enlarge our vision of knowing God in the purpose of our calling. 2 Timothy 1:9, that God saved us and called us for our God's work or accomplishment, but according to His purpose and grace, which was given to us in Christ Jesus before the world began. We are called for God's purpose and His grace. We are all called to reach out first for our family, to your friends, to your neighbor, to your country, and to the nation. This is what the Great Commission of God called for us. In Matthew 28:18-20, it says there, Jesus came and told His disciples, I have been given all authority in heaven and earth. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Teach them new disciples to obey all the commands I have given you. And be sure of this, I am with you always, even to the end of the age. In Acts 1:5-8, it says there, John baptized with water, but in a few days you will be baptized in the Holy Spirit. Then they gathered around him and asked him, Lord, are you at this time going to restore the kingdom of Israel? He said to them, it is not for you to know the time or dates of the Father has set by his Son, own authority, but you will receive the power from the Holy Spirit comes on you, and you will be my witness in Jerusalem, in all Judea, Samaria, and to the ends of the earth. Judea is our neighbor, the neighbor of the neighboring countries of Jerusalem. It's just beside it. Judea is our neighbor, the people around us, the close people that around us. This is our Judea. Samaria, it is some places, some area of our lives that we need to go place. These are the places where we cast out, you know, the cast out people, the places that we don't usually go. These are the people that we're not uncomfortable with. This is where we have to go. And to the ends of the earth, it is the farthest place that we can go. God was saying to us that God did not promise a straight road to that journey. My ride were very bumpy. I experienced a lot of things, trials and testings of my faith. But it keeps me going and grow more stronger in knowing the sovereign God. If you tested and seen the goodness of God in your life will never be the same again. As I studied His Word, He always showed me revelation of its refreshment of my spirit and strengthened my physical body as well. Our nourishment doesn't come from the food that we eat, but it is not by bread, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God. We know that our lives is just temporarily in this world. Maybe we can see that, you know, our loved ones is here today, but we cannot know the future. That's why the urgency of the Word of God to spread not only to other people, but most especially to your loved ones, to your relatives, to your families, to your friends, are seeking that urgency. Because we can see that the COVID-19, we lose a lot of people, we lose a lot of friends, we lose a lot of elderly, especially in Australia. And we know that the enemy is the one doing this. We have to bind ourselves in prayer, crying out to God about how this will gonna end. We still have the future, we still have the hope that God still holds. You know, enlarging our vision of God is by intentionally doing God's agenda. It will keep us focused on the task. We can see that God has the power over everything else in this world. Like what Jesus did, He went to places where everyone doesn't want to go and started the conversation. We need to stretch more of what God can do for us and what He can still do for the kingdom of God. We have all the different giftings and all can be used for the kingdom expansion and rebuilding. We need to enlarge our visions, the God's plan of salvation. We know that all things are possible in Christ. It is all started from Him and it will accomplish through Him. We are God's vessels and the blessing of the blessings to others we need to be used by God for the urgency of the gospel to preach from Judea to Samaria and to the very ends of the earth. If we are afraid to open up our mouth to preach the gospel, tell your people tell the people your story of God's redemption and His great love and mercy, and the people will know the life that we live. Your story is God's greatness. For His glory alone, we are simply spreading Jesus, His life and death, and most especially His resurrected power over our lives. In summary, we know that we had to enlarge our prayer, believe the power of prayer, humble our faith, and enlarging our vision of God. These are some areas that we need to be evident in our lives. Taking a clear stand, who is our final authority in our decisions and our belief, and we will take actions on how you view God. Be intentionally with people, be personal and with passion. Know that the purpose and understand that you're calling. Have a clear view of who and what is the final authority that God speaks into your life. Open our eyes that we may see God, that God is still in control. Even in the situation that doesn't see people of the future and the hope. You are God's mouthpiece, and for His grace of encouragement, not discouragement. God's vessels to open an opportunity of blessing to others, and the light of God that will shine forever, so whenever we go. So I encourage everyone that take this opportunity of this COVID-19 to reach out for our families, especially now the Turning Point had been launching the Alpha Talk, Alpha Marriage. Let us all pray. God, we are praying, Father God, for your goodness, O Lord God, to end the COVID-19, Lord. Lord God, we pray as well, O Lord God, that God, for the opportunity to use the situation to share the gospel to all people. God, we pray, Father, Lord God, for your grace and mercy to give us, O Lord God, the boldness in preaching His word, Lord. Lord God, we pray and we are so thankful, O Lord God, for the manifestation of your Holy Spirit, O Lord God, and for the glory of the miracles that have been still working behind the scene, Lord. Lord God, we are so thankful for the things that you're still doing in our lives. We pray, Father, Lord God, for us to teach us, O Lord God, how to pray and to have a boldness in reaching out the unsaved loved ones, O Lord God, our families and our friends, for the urgency of the gospel to be preached, Lord. Lord God, we are so thankful for your word today, Lord God, giving us another strength of opportunity, O Lord God, that we can share the gospel to all people, O Lord God. And all these things, O Lord God, that we ask, in Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Salamat po sa pagsama niyo po sa amin sa pag-aaral ng salita ng Panginoon. Nawa sa susunod na linggo, samahan niyo po ulit kami sa pag-aaral ng salita ng Diyos. Kung kayo po ay may katanungan or merong gusto po malaman, bisitahin po lamang kami sa Turning Point Filipino Outreach Facebook page, at kayo po ay malugod po nasasagot sa inyo. Hanggang sa muli po, mga kapatid. Maraming salamat po.